Welcome to another episode of Careers Express, brought to you by the Cyprus Mail, where job seekers and professionals can stay up to date with what matters most in our world of work. Today, we will look at the differences between millennials and Gen Z in terms of their generational skill sets, their professional aspirations, and their unique workplace concerns and needs. Joining me for our discussion is Senior Admissions Counselor at University of Nicosia, Galina Constantinides. Galina, welcome. It's great to have you with us.
Thank you, Elisabeth. Thank you for having me. And thank you for this amazing opportunity to discuss such a vital and important and current topic regarding our new generation coming and the generation that is already in the mid-careers. And these two generations right now shape the educational and the job market.
So let's dive into our questions. First of all, we often hear the word millennials, and now we're more recently Generation Z when it comes to education and the workplace. Could you give us a rough age range for each so we're clear who we're talking about?
Absolutely. And let me tell you that for the today's session, I will particularly use the Oxford Learnox Dictionary in order to give this specific definition of the age groups, because there are so many different variations of the age groups on the internet. And just to stick and be sure what we are referring to in this session. So according to the Oxford Learnox Dictionaries, Generation millennials were born between the early 1980s until later 1990s. So if we take a range, which will be 1981 to 1996, and mostly children born in that time were baby boomers' children. So we're talking about population which right now is approximately 72 million members of the global population. And if we're talking of early or mid-career age group, we're talking about 25 to 40 years old for the millennials. And if we talk about the Generation Z, those were born between the age between late 1997 and early 2010s. So we're talking again approximately of 67 million, and we're talking about an age group that is right now entering the job market and the universities. Approximately age is 24, and the youngest will be early teens of approximately 11 years old, and they're still not in a voting age. So just to capture the most important part here will be that generation of the millennials were born in an economic boom, whereas the generation of the Z were born and raised in recession. And as we can see, current events and previous events during that time has formed their characteristics.
What would you say are the main values and interests of Gen Z as a generation in contrast to millennials?
That's a very interesting question as well, because they are main differences. And I would say that they're really strong. In some parts, they will overlap with some similarities. So if we talk about the millennials, sometimes they're called the me generation. As we said, they were born in an era of economic prosperity and focused on the self. They were raised by helicopter parents. This is another term used for the parents that were raising those this generation, as they were hovering on top of them and nurturing for all their needs. And it is very important to mention here that millennials are more idealistic, more confrontational, and they're less willing to accept diverse points of view. Also here, it is important to mention that millennials see work as a calling instead of a job. And I have seen it here many, many times. And sometimes with students coming and advising them, I had to really take a strong look to define what a career means. And that is one main characteristic. Millennials are looking to make an impact, and that's why we see a lot of them now following certain causes like becoming vegan, fighting for the human rights, fighting for the racial differences, and so forth. But it is important to mention that in contrast, the Generation Z, it's a very diverse generation. The diversity is in their norm, as we see that this will be the most diverse generation from all. And of course, they're digital natives. We see from little toddlers walking with their smartphones and their tablets, playing games. So this is what they're used to. And of course, sometimes we might see that they're multitasking and texting and doing other things, and we might consider that they're not paying attention, but this is part of their nature, being able to listen, but at the same time multitasking and doing some other stuff, not necessarily not paying attention, of course. The Generation Z are very pragmatic, I would say, and they're very strongly financially minded. They are very savvy for saving their financial situations. Yes, thank you. At the same time, we see that because they have started earning from a very early age, most of them pioneered and were becoming entrepreneurs at early age, as early as 13. They were streaming videos on music channels and making a living, or earning on YouTube or TikTok, becoming influencers and so forth. And of course, they're very politically progressive. I'm sure you remember Greta Thunberg, example, such a strong activist for environmental movement. And with her influence, she managed to reach millions across the social media in an instant. And that is very important for the Generation Z. The millennials, on the other side, are strong following a cause, but they haven't been so good at such a widespread outreach. And of course, millennials are, as we said, are more idealistic. Comparing again the millennials and the Generation Z, we could say that Generation Z are very shrewd customers. They will go for their experience, whereas millennials will be committed and will go for the brand, and they will stick to the brand. Whereas Generation Z will not mind the brand as long as the experience is strong and satisfying. So I hope this captures
the main very much so
difference.
Yeah. In your capacity as UNIC Senior Admissions Counselor, you've seen young people at the start and end of their academic careers. What were the skills and aspirations of millennial freshmen compared to Gen Z freshmen?
Very good question. The difference is that Generation Z are more interested to learn. They're very competitive, and they're strong-willed, and they're focused in terms of where they want to end up. They have a vision. They have grew up in financial difficulties, so they are ambitious to achieve things. And they're very much centered to get the job done. And that is one of the main differences that I see from the millennials, who were more idealistic and they were going more for the learning experience, to grow and to be part of a team, to do collectively learning and other stuff and go for a cause and so forth. Whereas the Generation Z, we see that they're much more ambitious, I would say. Since they're entering now the university, we see that they're showing a really strong will to be successful. And that is a very strong and important characteristic, I would say.
You've also mentioned Gen Z described as digital natives, while millennials were the last generation to experience life before the internet. In your opinion, does tech familiarity help or hinder the confidence of millennials and Gen Z students during their time at UNIC?
I would say definitely helping and building the confidence and giving them a very strong professional skill to utilize in the workplace, but mm-hmm. also to make them successful at a university. Millennials, as you said, are the pioneers of the digital age. Z generation were born into it. I believe that as technology advances, we will see more and more need for tech skills. And of course, that skills will be much more advanced, such things as programming, virtual reality, and so forth. And of course, here, I would like to mention that at the University of Nicosia, we play a great emphasis on teaching our students these technical skills so they can enter the job market, because that is very important asset, and it is required by all organizations in today's reality. And so all our programs require a computer science specific course, and students have the options to choose, but we build further their confidence and prepare them for the job requirements.
So for the job requirements, what are some of the challenges that your Gen Z students have for their later professional life? And how are these similar or different from UNIC millennial students?
I would say that the millennial generation were more team-oriented, learning in a collective and team environment, whereas Gen generation, as we see now, are, because of COVID and after COVID effect, they have been exposed to this new online learning, but we see that they're looking for more new ways to learn, and they're looking for hands-on experiences because this is the way that they trigger that interaction which they're lacking because of their nature being so, you know, technologically savvy and growing up into the digital age, where they're kind of distanced from each other because they spend most of their time on a smartphone or tablet or laptop. So definitely I would say that the main difference here would be in the challenges is how to offer a better learning experience for the Generation Z and to employ new learning methodologies. And that will include more adding the hands-on experience. And something that we do here again at the University of Nicosia, we have introduced two new experiences for our new incoming students and teens that are looking into different opportunities to enter university. One is the student for a day experience, where we give them a hands-on experience to come and be part of the student life and student community for a day. And the second is different workshops, where we put them in small groups and they have hands-on a specific experience. For example, for our pharmacy major, they will be designing a little bulbs or face creams or hand cream. And this way we engage them much deeper into the experience so they can live it and have a better understanding of where they're going to go and understand the profession and the learning experience, of course. So these are these two good examples, I would say, that we as a university are employing in order to overcome these new challenges that students will face.
What, in your opinion, in terms of skills, would help Gen Z students transition to the workplace?
One very important skill that we will see that it's coming, it's and something that Generation Z has, it's the multitasking. More and more, the job environment requires our generations to be multitasking and to be able to work on simultaneously on different projects and be efficient and have absolute end result. And of course, something that it's never too much to emphasize is the problem-solving skills, critical thinking skill, innovation, and creativity. These are also very important, and this will help. And of course, as a university, it's our job to teach problem solving, critical thinking, and being innovative and creative, and so they can be prepared. And we do, I would say, a very good job through our Career Success Center, which offers different opportunities and experiences so students can focus on the different aspects of all of this and prepare better for the job market, but also with university courses that we offer. And of course, it is always very important that the new organizations and the job market will require the ability to deal with complexity and ambiguity more and more in the future. And of course, something that it's very primary in our human nature, communication. Communication, it's a very important, I would say, skill, which it's the A and B and C of everything we do, because only through communication, and we have seen now more and more the importance of communication after COVID, but also Generation Z will have to learn more ways of better communicating as they were so distanced from each other, not only through COVID, but through the technology and so forth. So again, a good example here at the University of Nicosia, I would say, is that our program are structured in the way that we offer specific courses of teaching them business ethics, business and professional communications, so we can prepare them with this strong skill for the future work environment. And of course, since this is, as we said, a generation that was born in the digital age, digital and IT skills are very, very important. And we still continue to emphasize on this.
What does Gen Z expect from their prospective employers? And how is that different or similar to the expectations of millennial professionals?
From the perspective of the employer, I will say the Gen Z will expect continuous learning. They're one generation that they're savvy to learn, and they have done most of their learning on YouTube and the last 2 years in COVID with online education. But they will be very interested to continue, and they see that their growth on the job will be through learning and continuously growing. So it is important employees to understand that and to build within their organizations new ways of introducing that learning through hands-on experience, as I mentioned in my previous example as well. And of course, Gen that will be looking for being accepted as a diverse generation. So diversity and inclusion will be very important for organizations to understand and to offer the comfort for them to be accepted in that concept. And of course, supervisors and managers, it will be very important for the Generation Z to check on them, on their employees, to make sure that they feel like their voice is heard. They can offer something more of a value to the organization. And of course, Generation Z, I believe, are that generation that will try to keep the balance the most from all other generations, and especially from the millennial, between work and life. And as we see, that will be a generation that is going to mostly be affected by mental health. And it is important to understand, and employers to offer that work and life balance.
With all those characteristics for Gen Z, so what changes do you believe Gen Z will bring to Cyprus work culture?
Very interesting question, which will definitely is touching on the future of work. And here for Cyprus, that will be very interesting, because as we know, Cyprus is a small island, and most of the companies here are small to medium family-owned businesses. We just now see a leap forward of this, some of the small to medium companies growing and becoming big multi-dimensional companies and multinational companies. One such example might be given as the University of Nicosia with its growth. So talking about what needs to change in the work culture, I would say definitely because Generation Z is a more practical generation, there are hands-on experience, as we said before. So organizations and will have to be able to offer this new learning experience in order to facilitate Generation Z to grow on their professions. And because they have the technical skills, and they believe that everything they learn on the job is directly related, and it is, if you ask me, to their career growth. So they will demand that new learning. And of course, I would say that interaction and offering these new learning experiences will be a big challenge for the Cyprus work culture. And of course, because Generation Z, it's one of the generations that mental health plays a big role, and we have seen it after COVID, that it's a very important topic. These organizations will have to incorporate to provide work and life balance to their employees. And that is something that will be constructive for the Generation Z, I would say.
Having said that, would you say the Cyprus workplace is meeting the concerns of Gen Z job seekers and employees?
I believe that they're definitely improving and growing, and there is still place to improve and grow. And we will see these changes happening as the environment requires it. So I'm confident that the Cyprus job culture will be changing and evolving. And I'm very positive that they will be able to grasp this task and deliver at a higher level.
So much to think about. Thank you. Before we go, do you have any final thoughts?
My final thought, and something as a message to Generation Z, will be that they would definitely need to continue learning and utilize every opportunity to learn, and emphasize even on the traditional learning and dive deep into this learning experience, because only through learning in depth, they will be able to become the experts and the professionals in the best version that they can. And that is something very important. And of course, a message to all out there, career seekers, job seekers, university students, is to strategize their career, because only through envisioning and building up strategies to reach that vision, they will reach the career goal that they are seeing at the end of their vision.
Thanks so much for sharing this valuable insight.
Thank you, Elisabeth. And again, thank you for inviting me today. And if anyone would like to see more, a little bit about the University of Nicosia, I will say that they can visit our website, www.unic.ac.cy. They can follow us, especially we're very proud that we have announced our new University of Nicosia Metaverse experience on New York Times Square. And this is all over our Instagram, our Facebook, our LinkedIn, and our Twitter. So follow the University of Nicosia. We have amazing knowledge and experience to share. So visit our social accounts.
Thanks also to you, our Careers Express viewers, for joining us. If you found this video useful, please like, share, and subscribe to this channel, and follow us on our social media as well. See you in a new video very soon.